everybody. Today we're making some coconut shrimp with a nice sweet and spicy apricot sauce on it that you're gonna love. This makes a great appetizer. I tried making this originally in the oven, trying to be super healthy, and it didn't have the wow factor that I like to bring to you guys. So we're sauteing it on the stove in some avocado oil to keep it as healthy as we can. These are so delicious, guys. It is so worth it. Not something you're gonna eat every day, but you're gonna love this recipe. I'm Rockin' Robin, and I'm gonna show you how to do it right after our chef joke. All right, I like to start off with chef joke number one. Number two will be just a little bit later. So why don't shrimp like basketball? Because they're afraid of the net. So we're gonna start off talking about our shrimp. I'm using wild caught. I always try and buy my fish wild. I feel it's just a bit better and healthier. And these have their shells still on and their tails, so I'm gonna have to clean them up, and I'm gonna show you a little bit on how to do that. And these are 16 to 20 to the pound, so they're not super large and they're not super small. You want it to be kind of nice and medium size. And that way you have a nice appetizer when you're, you know, after you cook them up. Once your shrimp are defrosted, they're soft. I'm running these under cold water. You always want to do cold water. Then I'm going to start taking off the shell. Okay. So you just kind of start, you start here where the little feet are, and you start peeling it, you know, off like this, and you just peel it off. Now we want to leave the tails on, so that way we have something to grab as an appetizer. So don't take all of it off. I'm leaving this last section, this section right here, I'm leaving it on. Okay, so I'm going to do that to the rest of these, and then we'll show you the next step on how to devein them. Okay, so what we want to do now that we've taken the shells off, we need to devein them, which means we're going to cut along this area right here, the spine area, and just kind of expose it. So you don't make too deep of a cut, just deep enough. And you're gonna see like this black in there, and that's what we wanna remove. So I will run this under the water and pull this out. So just to make it easy, I'm gonna go ahead and slice them all, then I'll rinse them all at the same time. Now there's another place that you can also do this, and that is on the underside here. So you can actually see it, the black little streak there. So I'm going to go ahead and do a little slice there, and again you can see it, you see that, and then I'll just pull that out. So I have all the shrimp sliced, and now we're going to rinse them all at the same time. And it's important to pat your shrimp dry before we put them in the fridge. So now the shrimp are all nice and clean, I'm just going to cover them with some saran wrap and place them back in the fridge for a few minutes. This is how we're going to set up for dipping our shrimp into the coating. Our first station on the right is basically flour and some spices. Our second is an egg wash, and our last one is some coconut and panko breadcrumbs. So in our first dipping station, I've got some Bob's Red Mill 1-to-1 baking flour here that's gluten-free. You can use regular flour. We're going to add some chili powder to this. Give it a little bit of heat, a little bit of interest. Garlic powder. And you can get all the written ingredients below the video. Click in the description area and you'll see that. And some salt. So then we'll just combine this together until it's all evenly distributed. Dipping station number two is our egg. Now you'll use one or two eggs just depending on how many shrimp you're cooking. So I'm gonna start with one. If I need more, I can always add another one. Dipping station number three just entails two ingredients. We have our shredded coconut here. This is unsweetened. I like to use unsweetened. And I actually took mine and put it in a food processor to kind of break it down a little bit smaller so it wasn't really big. What happens if it's really long and big? It tends to burn. So that's why I did that. And then here we've got some panko breadcrumbs by Aleias. And these work really great. This helps with a nice crispy exterior. So I'm just gonna combine the two together, and that's station number three. So now we're gonna make our apricot dipping sauce. So I picked up a jar of this, it's called Intense Apricot Fruit Spread, has low sugar, 8 grams of sugar per tablespoon, which is kind of on the low side. So anyway, find something that's not too chunky because you want it to be relatively smooth. And we're gonna add some Annie's Organic Horseradish Mustard to this. And this is gonna give it a little bit of a kick. And you can taste it to see what, you know, to see how you like it. You can add more or less. To that, we're gonna add some rice vinegar. And I have some fresh lemon juice. And this is actually fresh. I got this from my freezer because I store it. I had a big load of lemons and I froze quite a bit of it. And then I pull out what I need. And then we're gonna add a few of these crushed red pepper flakes. And you can just add as much of that as you like the heat. And then we'll start with our first dipping station here. I'm just gonna lay them in there and coat them. Shake off any excess. Now we're going into the egg mixture. And then we go into the shredded coconut and panko crumbs. And then we'll just lay it right there on the plate, and that's ready to go. Before we get into cooking our shrimp, we have time for chef joke number two. All right, here we go. Why did the cook fry the shrimp? Because it was having a tempura tantrum. Now, we want to preheat our pan. So I have a cast iron pan here, not too big. I'm gonna cook about six in here at a time. So I'll do it in two batches. Get my temperature up to medium high. We want this oil to be about 350 degrees when we start cooking it. So I'm gonna pour enough in here to just really cover the bottom and maybe come up just a bit. Let's start with that. But we don't wanna start cooking until this oil is hot, and we can test it with an instant read thermometer, which we'll do in a little bit. Okay, so our temperature is 350 or thereabouts, and so we'll get started. Okay, so we're gonna place the shrimp in the pan. Try not to overcrowd them so they'll crisp up nicely. You may have to turn up the heat after we add all the shrimp because it'll lower the temperature of the oil. And I have a plate over here with some paper towels, which when they're done, I'll place it on that. So now I'll just cook up the second batch, add a little oil to the pan if needed, and then we're ready to eat them. All right, so one more thing. I have a little bit of lemon juice left over. So I'm going to just drizzle a little bit of that over it. I think it'll just really brighten it up. And then you get to dig in. I can't wait. Dip it into that sauce. Did you hear the crunch? God, I love that crunch. Cooking them on the stove like I did is way better than in the oven. Much more flavor. It's just the way to do it. These are so good, guys. You gotta try them. Let me know what you think down in the comments. And thank you so much for watching. I do appreciate it. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the old notification bell so that you'll know when my new videos come out. And also, if you like the video, smash the old like button for me. It really helps me out. All right, we'll see you next week, everybody.